Namaste. Welcome from Dhananjay Kumar to this series on raising intelligent kids. In a couple of earlier episodes, I had explained the concept of infinity and the largest number. Today, I am going to raise the possibility of something bigger than infinity. Good question. Came to my mind recently. I said, I found something that is bigger than infinity. And the answer is very simple. If you look at our conscious mind, which means the waking state mind, which is a small fraction of the total big mind that we have or we are part of. So in the waking state mind, which is a tiny proportion of our total mind, we can imagine infinity, idea of infinity. A small quantity can be divided into infinite numbers, even if it is not a number. The idea is you can continue to divide it. You will never reach zero. Similarly, in time dimension, some existence, some dimension outside of the time frame, you can imagine something very large, you can't even quantify, but you can imagine. So, the imagination of our mind, waking state mind, which is a small percentage of big mind, that waking state mind, I would say, is bigger, much bigger than infinity. Now, in addition to the waking state mind, it is not really a clear distinction, clear dividing line, but we have subconscious mind. Subconscious mind is connected with all of humanity. We share subconscious mind. So one person or one individual with strong energy and intention to do good or bad has a tiny influence on the subconscious mind level of the larger community or the whole humanity. Similarly, a group of people with certain characteristics would, in the long run, share or impart that knowledge, awareness to the others who are unknown to them. And there have been scientific studies how certain animals, a group of animals, taken away, some were left behind, some were taken away to an island far away, and through generations these two groups never came in contact. But one group's habits, preferences became native, inherent in the other group without the two groups ever meeting for generations. Now, even bigger than the subconscious mind, of course, subconscious mind is another angle. It creates your dreams. It creates you in the dream. It creates impossible events, impossible situations that happen in your dream, and it looks very real. Only when you get up, you realize that it was a dream. But in dream, you don't know it is a dream. And of course, the enlightened ones would be conscious of the waking state. They will know that this is waking state. And in dream, they will know this is dream. And in deep sleep, when there is no dream, they will also know this is deep sleep, in which you are close to being dead, because all the system slows down, your breathing slows down, there are no dreams, you are totally at rest. That is deep sleep. And deep sleep is connected not only to the whole humanity, but to whole creation. And this three ways of looking at the mind is explained in one of the Upanishads. Waking, dreaming, sleeping. And a fourth state, which is the witness to these three, is called Turiya situation, Turiya avastha, that is conscious of all these three states. Now, if your waking state, a small fraction, can imagine infinity and beyond, you can say infinity times infinity, or infinity plus one, then the subconscious mind is bigger than the waking state, and the unconscious mind is even bigger. So I would say, your mind, and mine too, is much bigger than infinity. That's a very sobering and enlightening idea, that you dwell upon it and you will discover new layers of your being that you have never known before. And with that knowledge, you can grow, evolve, become more intelligent. And this is the message to the children of today's world. Thank you for listening.